Germans at the bridge at Remagen. I went to Ole Miss. I ran the rebel flag at the Natchez pageant. If I'd been alive in 1865, I'm sure I would have fought for the Confederacy. Now, that's the preface. But I'm also the guy who, with John Grisham, organized just about every writer in Mississippi, and Archie Manning, and Morgan Freeman, and Jimmy Buffett, and the SEC coaches, to get rid of the damn flag. You are being asked to train and serve underneath the battle flag of an army that existed solely to keep your ancestors in slavery for all time. That is immoral. It is obscene. That is not acceptable, okay, on a human level. Second, I want to talk about the monuments just one second. There's a lot of feelings about the monuments right now. Let me tell you. I've walked every foot of Gettysburg, from Little Round Top to the wheat field to the peach orchard. My dad has more Civil War books than anybody in Mississippi. I know the whole history argument. But let me tell you where we're headed. We're going to see this within 2 weeks. A black boy and a black girl, or some young white college kids, are going to get arrested somewhere for pulling down or blowing up a Confederate monument. And then they're going to go to trial, and they're going to be looking at jail time. And the United States of America is going to be looking at its law enforcement authorities possibly sending black kids to jail for blowing up a monument to people who wanted to keep them in slavery forever. That is not going to fly. The monuments are going to go away, y'all. It's never going to be 1950 again. And it's never going to be 1850 again. It's just over. And everybody's going to have to adjust to it in their own way. But for God's sake, as a white Mississippian, speaking of white Mississippians, let's don't be the last ones clinging to the flag and the monument. Because, folks, we've been last in everything for so long, I can't remember. And if we keep clinging to that crap, we're going to be last for 75 more years, and you might as well just give it up and move away. That is the hard truth. So please don't do it. I don't care if you're Republican or Democrat or whatever you are. Don't elect short-sighted people with character insufficient to the historical moment in which we find ourselves. Rise above.